And we're covering game number three of the 2014 FBA Finals. I'm Team Matt Leitrim, your Coyote on the court, and I am joined in the commentary booth by some shadowy figure sitting there in the darkness with me, red, yellow eyes staring at me, looking into my soul. I believe it's Damian Williams in there. Hey there, Damian.
Hey, how's it going, Tim?
Yeah, it's going good. It's going real good. But in any case, we are covering game three here. This is the first game of this series here in Edmonton. Tennessee Moonshiners up 2-0. Totems yet to win a game in the series. You know, I was just thinking to myself, last finals, Edmonton Totems, their very first year in the FBA, did a phenomenal job, made it all the way to the Western Conference Finals, unheard of in FBA history, got blown out 0-4 against the Dakota Bikers. It would be a shame if they took a step forward into the finals and went 0-4 in this series.
That would be a hard, especially in the finals. You never want to see a sweep, man. You want to see a good competitive series.
Absolutely, no doubt. There's the tip-off, and we're going the Totems' way. That's a good start for them. Parsons picks up the ball. Deep woods, he's got guarded by Fisher. Hands off to Caracol. Caracol, who very weak in the last game. Let's see if he can strengthen up his match here today. Frola now in the starting line. He's got the rock. Hierarchy pass, finds Hicks back to the basket. Coy Dog kicks it out. Caracol back in the woods. Running out of time. Caracol cross court. Dangerous to Parsons. Parsons hits the shot from 22.
And that's big, man. That's a big first score for Edmonton.
That was big. They're under pressure there. I got to admit, I was a little surprised. Caracol decided not to take the shot himself. Went with a dangerous pass. But he was able to get it to Parsons, and the Otter was able to sink it there with his feet on the arc.
Well, and you can't be tentative if you're Rocky Caracol, man. You got to shoot. You're the MVP. Like, this team needs you.
Wondegoyak now with the rock. He's running out of time. Only got 2 seconds to shoot. Takes the three. Back of the iron. Not really his shot. Parsons comes up with it, and the Otter taking it back up court. He lets it loose. No good. Barry
Rocky
Carpenter
missed a wide open three in transition. That's not going to happen often.
Kick out back to Carpenter. He was able to make the rebound for this possession. Goes cross court. Finds Fisher opposite shoulder. Pump fake. Drives himself away from the high post. No good. Bounce all the way around the iron, but came off. Recovered by the Totems. Caracol bringing it up. Pass over to Parsons. He is at the elbow, but pulls back out into the woods. The Otter now, deep woods. Guarded by Velasquez. There's a mismatch going on there. Will he be able to find it and take advantage? Got a lot of isolation there. Taking it himself inside. Hicks, Lenny Hicks with the bucket off the glass.
And that's what you need from Lenny Hicks, man. That's what he does. Those garbage buckets underneath.
That was a perfect Lenny Hicks play there. You're absolutely right. The big hybrid, very solid down low. And speaking of down low, Aragon Fisher curling his way all the way to the baseline, getting the easy layup, bypassing all the defense.
That was that's what we call that ole defense. He goes, ole, let them go right by.
Beautiful job. From three, Frola. No good. Back of the iron. Recovered by Fisher. Going the other way. Otter brings it up. Deep woods for him. Caracol guarding. Cross court, finds Velasquez. Back to Fisher. Still guarded by Caracol. Deep woods. He goes to the top of the arc. Still holding on to it. Hands off to Mondegoyak from three. No good. Back of the iron. But big rebound by PT. Hands off to Carpenter. And the Beaver from Kentucky makes it off the glass.
See, now, again, we talked about rebounding. Second chance points. Edmonton cannot get beat on the backboards.
Tied up, four apiece. 9.25 minutes left in the first. Frola, deep woods. Tabby from Underwood's been solid for the rest of the series here. Caracol from three, and he switches it in.
See, that was nice. See, they're running him off a lot of screens, trying to free him up, get him going early, and I think that's smart.
Not bad either. He had, Velasquez guarding. Tough to make those shots over the big wing. But that time, Caracol able to sink it with a step away from the arc. Makes it a 4-7 game. 9 minutes left in the first. Behind the back pass. Velasquez just outside the elbow. And she hits it right off the glass and in.
What a series Jamie Velasquez has been having.
No doubt. No doubt. I got to tell you that if the Moonshiners do pull off the series, it's going to be a big question. Who would be MVP, PT or Velasquez? And if Velasquez is in there, that's going to be FBA history right there, considering her career. Cross court. Parsons with a rock. He's at the shoulder. The Otter driving to the free throw line. He kicks out. Frola running out of time. The Tabby from 22. In and out. No good. Hicks, though, with the recovery. Turn around. Puts it up. No good, but he gets the foul. That's on Aragon Fisher, his first personal. And that will put the hybrid at the line for two.
And what did we talk about at the start of the game? Lenny Hicks down low, getting boards, easy bucket, second chance opportunities. Like, I think it was a great move putting Lenny at the four.
You're absolutely right. I mean, Lenny Hicks as a natural power forward, for those who have been watching the FBA, I mean, of course, the big battle in the four position has been between Charles Yodicek, of course, one of my favorite personal players, and Lenny Hicks being kind of that second best in that position. But Lenny Hicks has, in fact, had years where he's done better than Chuck Yodicek, and this is one of them. I mean, this is really his place to be at the number four. Kind of a surprise to put him at number three, but it just goes with this kind of wall of meat strategy that we've been seeing getting more and more popular.
I never understood that, man. I would love for Lenny Hicks to guard me on the perimeter. I'm just saying, they can't stay with these quicker guards and forwards.
No, you're absolutely right. I mean, the bigger the body, the slower the legs, and that's something we have seen in this series. And
good take right there,
Eric on Fisher taking it right into the trees.
And how about Fisher versus Parsons, man? Like, that's been a great battle, Otter versus Otter, man.
No doubt, absolutely. And I mean, it's hard to tell who's been better, Parsons and Fisher, both of them doing a phenomenal job leading their teams, doing a great job being these driven point guards.
Oh,
but there,
you can't miss layups, James.
Yeah, for James Vastrikiel missing a perfectly good layup. Absolutely no excuse for missing that one. Going the other way after the amazing layup from Fisher. And then there, from 20 feet out, Uriak Monegoyak able to snap the twine with his paws on the arc.
And now Tennessee leads 10-9 with 7:30 left. So, I mean, back and forth we go.
This is going to be one of those games, definitely. Pass over to Frola. Frola finds a quick pass.
There's Lenny Hicks again, and that was a great. See, Parsons was able to handle the double team. Great ball movement. They got it downloaded to Lenny Hicks. And again, Lenny Hicks, man on the spot.
Beautiful job there. The Koi Dog was in the right position at the right time. Got a little clumsy there under the hoop, but he still was able to make the basket go down and get the two. Edmonton leads by one. Tennessee 10, Edmonton 11. 7 minutes left in the first. Fisher, yet again, low post, puts it up. Didn't go in, but he was able to draw a foul on his opposing Otter. Parsons picks up his first personal. And Fisher will go to the line for two.
And again, like, this is probably the battle to watch all series. I mean, Fisher and Parsons have kind of canceled each other out. So it's up to the guys that are around them to kind of, you know, pick up the slack. And last time it was Tennessee's bench in game two. I could not believe. Was it 50, 51 points that they scored? It was unbelievable.
Outrageous. Absolutely outrageous. You know, it's remarkable when you think about the fact that the Moonshiners have a reputation for being a high defensive team, but they have been very offensive in this series. They have really stepped up the scoring, doing a phenomenal job hitting the bottom of the net. Good with both. Tennessee takes the lead again. Tennessee 12, Edmonton 11, 7 minutes in the first. Caracol brings it up himself. The MVP, guarded by Velasquez. Still holding on to it. Pump fake, but then hands off to Parsons. Wide open shot. In and out. No good. Hicks right there. Not able to make the basket go down, but he draws a foul.
Lenny Hicks. It's basketball is a very simple game. Like, I'm just going to throw that out there. Lenny Hicks is a beast underneath. And I think Edmonton, you're seeing it right now. The simple switch to put him back at the four, he's more aggressive. He's more comfortable. He doesn't have to run around on the defensive end guarding Monegoyak. It was a brilliant move by the head coach.
Absolutely. We are already seeing dividends from moving Lenny Hicks to the four here. Hicks has already gotten lots of touches in the low kennel. He has been making good baskets and getting lots of points. I mean, this is obviously already, it's very clear that this is the position that the Koi Dog needs to be in.
And he's done a great job, again, just getting offensive rebounds and doing a job on PT and keeping him off the offensive glass. Like, he does all of the little things that are boxing out, setting screens that go unnoticed, too.
Good with both. Edmonton takes the lead again. Tennessee 12, Edmonton 13.
I believe we call this a seesaw battle.
No, it's just going to be one for a while. I get the feeling. Tennessee with a rock. Aragon Fisher brings it up off the inbound. Deep pass finds Velasquez near the elbow. She takes a step away, though. Still holding on to the ball. She's just inside the arc. Drives to the baseline. Loses it, though. Vastrikiel's got it. The Bear picks it up, and he brings it up himself.
Give it to a guard.
I was about to say, James, give it away, for heaven's sake. But then,
bad pass.
Sloppy pass from, oh my goodness, Parsons finding a player who had a paw on the line. That's an out-of-bounds call, and we're going the other way.
Probably saw somebody in a jersey on the sidelines and just blinked.
No doubt. There you go. He's, after the last two games, not used to be having a home crowd that's wearing their jerseys. Fisher now with a rock at the shoulder, cross court. Eve Pacias now on the floor. She has been a solid bench player in this series. Spin move, tries to get around the defense, but she has to get rid of it. Monagoriak, wide open. No good, though. Back of the iron, but it's recovered by Pacias. Beautiful job by the Crocodile to keep that ball alive. Fresh 24. Hand off to Fisher at the shoulder. Guarded by Parsons. Monagoriak driving near the baseline. Finds the elbow, cross the kennel. Pacias, no good with that basket. Rolled off and recovered by the Totems. Caracol's bring it the other way. Caracol takes it all the way to the baseline. Kisses the elbow, but then steps back out. Hands off to Marco Sly, now on the floor, cross court. Frolla with it. Frolla goes across the arch. Goes into the near Woods. Hand off to Caracol. Bump fake. Beautiful job. Stepped up to the elbow. Puts it up and hits the basket.
Got him with the eyebrow fake. That was a great pump fake.
Beautiful job. Rocky Caracol throwing off Aragon Fisher. Totally getting the otter to bite on that pump. And then stepping in, top of the elbow, easy bucket for the MVP.
See, you could tell that's a crafty veteran move. You just get that little eyebrow fake and then take a step inside and hit the jumper. And a pretty competitive game that we've seen so far. I'm very impressed.
So far, definitely. Edmonton feeling very comfortable with the crowd cheering for them. Tennessee calls a timeout. Tennessee 12, Edmonton 15. 5.25 minutes left in the first.
I think the interesting thing about this game, it's going to come down to these benches at some point. Like, whose bench, again, game two, it was all Tennessee. But I think Edmonton has to rise to the challenge, and those bench players have to come in, and they have to have a chip on their shoulder.
Blind pass, cross court. Fisher, deep Woods. Holding on to it, isolating. Then he hands off to Goyak at the shoulder, guarded by Frolla. The Wolverine hands off to Random, back on the court. Random running out of time from the corner. Back of the iron, no good. Frolla with the rebound, and the tabby from Underwood brings it back.
There's a lot of guys from Underwood I've noticed in the league.
Oh, without a doubt. Underwood College has just got one of the most amazing programs you'll find in any Kafuri university.
Ooh, that's going to count. That's a goaltend on Monagoriak.
Frolla there got down low, getting aggressive. Monagoriak touching the ball on the downward motion, so count the bucket even though it didn't go in. That puts Tennessee at 12, Edmonton up by 5, 17, 4.5 minutes left in the first.
I got to say, I got a lot of respect for referees when they got to make that goaltending call, because that's probably one of the hardest things to judge, especially with the athleticism in the FBA these days.
No, no doubt. And there's a block. Beautiful job there. Marco Sly getting a raccoon paw on the rock and swatting it back. It were going the other way. Edmonton with a chance to extend their lead. Parsons, deep Woods, hands off to Fiora. Inside, Songhua, in and out, no good.
And I think this is interesting. It's Scott Parsons and four bench guys, so we'll see what happens.
Soars now, finds Jung, cross court, Random there. Back to the Arctiopteryx. I'm getting better at saying that. Anika Jung.
That was impressive.
Yeah, it's taking a while. Hierarchy pass, too high arcing, and the ball goes out of bounds after a sloppy pass there.
Hey, that was good defense. You see they're trying to front the post, and that was just he threw a little bit too far over the top.
Huck and Storrs sending the ball over the baseline, and that will send the ball the other way. It's still Tennessee 12, Edmonton 17, 4 minutes left in the first. Inbound, Sanford Thiessen takes it. The raccoon from Underwood College brings it in. Yes, another one from Underwood. There's a lot of them on this court.
I was going to say.
Thiessen, inside, it's blocked, stolen by Pacias. Going the other way, Annika Jung brings it up. There's a mismatch there. Looks like Songhua's guarding. Still guarding Annika Jung, still with it. She finally kicks it out back into the Woods. Cross court, back to Jung. Pump fake, but no bite from the defense. Holding on to it, running out of time though. Jung's gonna have to take the shot for himself from three. It's good!
Oh, that was from beyond area code range. My goodness, get a hand up.
Annika Jung, she has been so incredible in this series, definitely. The sixth player here for these Tennessee Moonshiners. And there, she shows her skill. Step away from the arc, just drilling it home from three. And it's answered by another three from Renee Fiora.
Oh, fluffy, stuffy splash.
She is keeping it fluffy this game. Renee Fiora with the easy three. Tennessee 15, Edmonton 20. 3 minutes left in the first. Random with a rock. Deep Woods. Top of the arc. Finds shoulder from three. Jung, back of the iron, no good. Song-Hwa picks it up. Biggest body under the hoop. Hands off to Fiora. Blind pass, Kazanishi at the elbow. But she's double-teamed. She doesn't get rid of it. Song-Hwa gets rid of it even further. Thiessen back in the woods. The raccoon curling. Then Kazanishi from the corner. It's good.
Uh-oh.
Another three. Kazanishi singing the three ball. Beautiful job there. Now she's come out of deep reserve from the first game, making a big difference here for this team. It looks like they're going to be running away with it a little bit here.
Look at this Totems bench right now. I mean, it's 23-15. They're going on a little bit of a run.
Absolutely. Tennessee Moonshine is not able to
mismatch. Mouse in the house. Get it to Song-Hwa.
that would be the thing. Yes, that get it to Song-Hwa, definitely. Romanarin over Eve Pacias, not a good enough mismatch. Pacias able to defend and able to pick up the ball. Stores
Song-Hwa had that little point guard. You got to recognize the mismatch there. Give it to the big man.
Yeah, I had to wonder what was difficult there. The pass was blocked. I didn't see. Looked like they had an open lane. Random, just inside the arc. Holding onto it, starts to dribble. Kicks out, Annika Jung at the shoulder. Annika Jung, crossover move. Tries to get around Fiora. Running out of time, lose it! But it was picked up by Griff Rasputin, but he was not able to get the ball off his paw in time. That's a shot clock violation. Going the other way with a minute 30 left on the clock.
That was great defense. I mean, it's really hard to strip a ball from a shooter like that. So to get your hand in there and knock that ball away, great, great defense.
Hand off to Thiessen. He brings it up after the inbound. The raccoon out of Underwood, guarded by Jung. Cross court, finds Kazanishi. Quick pass over to Murky on the opposite shoulder. Inside, Fiora back to the basket. She kicks it out. Back to Thiessen, deep woods, guarded by Jung. Murky, just inside the arc. Starts to dribble, running out of time though. Gonna have to take the shot, the weasel hits it! Beautiful job by Clyde Murky, under pressure, hitting the shot.
Now Edmonton is up by 10. I mean, this is you gotta be happy if you're with this first quarter if you're the Edmonton Totems.
I called him a weasel, he's a black-footed ferret. I'm very sorry for anyone who is offended. Kick out. From three, Butler. No good. The rookie not able to connect, but Griff Rasputin has the ball, and Griff Rasputin gets the second chance points and one.
That's Murky. A man's rebound.
Clyde Murky picks up his first personal as the big bear will go to the line for the potential three-point play.
That they got caught on a switch there, and they had the, I think that was Fiora underneath the basket. There's just no chance.
That was a beautiful job there by the veteran to be able to keep on the ball, get his paws around it, pick it up, and then have the mental ability to just power the ball through, get the bucket.
And he hit the free throw. And just like that, it's 25-18.
Beautiful job. 30 seconds left in the first. Hand off, Thiessen. The raccoon driving to the baseline. Pulls back, finds Murky wide open. That was a
good pass.
Collapse of the Tennessee defense, leaving the ferret wide open under the basket. Easy layup.
That's what you got to do when you can penetrate like that. When the big man comes over, you just drop it off. Easy layup.
Shot clock turned off. 15 seconds left in the first. Going all the way around the woods. Hand off to Jung, just inside the arc. Pine the back pass, finds Holly Barker. Back to Jung, the ladies. Passing the ball back and forth, running out of time. Jung, just outside the elbow, puts it up, and she hits the final bucket of the first quarter. 0.3 seconds left on the clock. Not enough time to let the ball off after the inbound.
You know, I got to say, that was a big-time shot because now you go into the second quarter with only a 7-point deficit with Edmonton up 27-20.